Hi friends, I welcome you all for the channel of your UPSC friend. In our series of modern Indian history, till now we have discussed the Regulating Act of 1773, Charter Act of 1813 and the Charter Act of 1853. In the coming days, let's see the Governor Generals associated with this period and the famous personalities and also associations of this period, that is from 1773 to 1853. Today, let's discuss regarding the Warren Hastings. Warren Hastings, his tenure was 1772 to 1785. He was the first Governor General of Bengal. He started his career as a writer or clerk in East India Company at Calcutta in 1750. This is the image of Warren Hastings. What was the condition of Bengal when Warren Hastings became the Governor General of Bengal? There was a utter chaos in Bengal administration. I hope you remember that what we discussed in the Regulating Act of 1773 and in Pitt's India Act of 1813, through which the British Parliament tried to control the East India Company, which had a huge corruption and maladministration in India. The second thing is the financial position of the company was worse, but the company officials were leading a lavishing life. And the third was the crisis of famine. Now let's see the reforms. The first was abolition of dual system. This dual system was introduced by Robert Clive. Under this dual system, there was two things. One is the Diwani and the Nizamat. Diwani is the right to collect taxes or revenues, which was under the British. And the second was Nizamat. That is the administration of military, police, judiciary and other administrative things, which was under the Nawab. The second reform was the East India Company was decided to collect Diwani by its own agents. The third, Nawab's allowance of 32 lakhs was reduced to half. That is, under the Allahabad Agreement, which was the outcome of Buxar War, the company and the Nawab were agreed to pay, that is, company agreed to pay 32 lakh rupees as the allowance for Nawab. Under the Warren Hastings, this 32 lakh rupees was reduced to half. The fourth reform was annual payment of rupees 32 lakh rupees to Mughal Emperor was stopped. That is, it was under the treaty between the Robert Clive and Shah Alam. They agreed to pay 26 lakh rupees as a tribute to Mughal Emperor was also came to end. Now, let's discuss regarding the revenue reforms. The first was for the revenue collection, the Warren Hastings established a board of revenue in Calcutta to supervise the revenue collection. The second thing was the British collectors were appointed for each district and an accountant general was also appointed to look after the revenue collection. To avoid the interference of Nawab of Bengal, Warren Hastings moved his treasury from Mushirabad to Calcutta and later Calcutta became the capital of Bengal, which in turn became the capital of India. The Board of Revenue auctioned the land for 5 years instead of 1 year. That is, the agricultural land was auctioning for 1 year. And under the Warren Hastings, now it was auctioning for 5 years. And there was also the arbitrary fines which were on the farmers. Now, this also was abolished. Now, let's see the judicial reforms. the judicial powers of the zamindars were abolished. And the Nawab, who was the chief administrator of the judiciary, and his powers of justice administration was misused. So this system was also abolished by Warren Hastings, and he prepared a complete structure for it. Each district provided the civil court under collector and criminal courts under Indian judge were established. The above it, two appellate courts were also established at Calcutta. The civil court called Sardar Diwani Adalat, presided by Governor General, and two judges recruited from members of his council. And the criminal appellate court called Sardar Nizamat Adalat was presided over himself by the governor. The criminal court is presided over by the Indian judge, who is appointed by governor in council. The Muslims were tried according to their Muslim laws in the Quran, and the Hindus were tried according to the Hindu law. A code of Hindu law prepared by Hindu pandits was translated into English. He also came down heavily on the dacoits on Bengal. Now let's see the trade regulation. Hastings abolished the system of dastaks, which we can also called as free passes for trade, which were misused by the company officials and traders earlier. He enforced a uniform tariff on both Indian and foreign goods of 2.5%. Private trade were also allowed, but only in the restricted manner. In the Calcutta, for the first time, banks were started under Warren Hastings. Treaties during the Warren Hastings period. The first was Rohilla War in 1774. Here, the Rohilakhand was a small kingdom between Oudh and Maratha, and Hafiz Rehmat Khan as its ruler. In 1772, Hafiz Rehmat Khan, that is the Rohilakhand ruler, signed a defensive treaty with the Nawab of Oudh. Because of the fear of attack of Marathas. But no war took place, but the Nawab of Oudh started demanding the money. Hafiz evaded. The Nawab of Oudh, with the help of British, invaded the Rohilkhand. This is regarding the Rohilla War of 1774. The second war that took place was the First Anglo-Maratha War, which was between 1775 to 1782. After the Battle of Panipat in 1761, Marathas remained to be disunited. This Panipat War of 1761 was between the Marathas and Ahmad Shah Abdali. There was a dispute between Marathas, that is Madhav Rao, and his uncle Raghunath Rao for the post of Peshwas. British authorities in Bombay signed a treaty of Surat with Raghunath Rao. Under this treaty, Raghunath Rao promised to cede Basin and Salsette to British, but later he refused to do it. So the British captured the Raghunath Rao. In 1776, Hastings sent Colonel Upton to settle the issue, and he cancelled the Surat agreement, and he concluded a new agreement called Treaty of Purandar with Marathas. According to it, Madhav Rao was accepted as a new Peshwa, and British retained Salsette, and there was a heavy war indemnity to be paid to the British by Marathas. Hastings called this treaty as just a scrap of paper, and he sanctioned the operation against Marathas, but the troop which came for the operation was defeated by Marathas. Then in 1781, Warren Hastings sent Captain Popham. He defeated the Marathas, especially Mahaji Scindia, and concluded the Treaty of Salbai. The Treaty of Salbai mainly has these provisions, that is, the Salsette and Basin given to British, Raghunath Rao pensioned off, and Madhav Rao II accepted as the Peshwa. These were the three terms under the Treaty of Salbai. First, it was Rohila War of 1774. The second happened was the First Anglo-Maratha War between 1775 to 1782. And the last war was the first Anglo-Mysore War, which we will see in the next video. By that, we will conclude Warren Hastings. The another thing to note here is the Regulating Act of 1773 and Pitt's India Act was also during the tenure of Warren Hastings. As I have already done a video on Regulating Act and Pitt's India Act, now I am skipping it. If you like my video, please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.